In this video, I show you how to construct a deterministic finite automaton for a language that's given in this case by a description. And this one is actually a bit tricky. It says the language is all words over the alphabet AB, in which every A is followed by AB. And there are some students pointing out, wait a moment, if every A shall be followed by AB, what about this A? And if this is followed by a B, by AB, then the previous one, which is shall be followed, isn't followed by AB. So, yeah, don't be too smart. Of course, it's then, in this case, it's for every A, but not for this A. Otherwise, it wouldn't be possible. So, I'm starting with my initial state. I name it Q0, and well, if every A shall be followed by AB, and there's no A in it, for example, the empty string, then there isn't an A in it for which the condition must be applied, so I will make this a final state as well. So, the empty string is in the language. Now, if I have a B, If my symbol is a B, then there's no condition specified for the B, so I can add as many Bs as I want. And, well, I write this as a loop here. Now, the special case applies when we are now detecting an A, and I need a new state for it. I name it Q1. So now, if we read any A, we want to make sure that this is read is followed by AB. And, well, in computational linguistics, we are allowed to use short forms, for example, like AB, but I don't need this here. I will use to another state, Q2. So, and here my AB, I can make this in color. So, every A, that is now this A, shall be followed by AB, and this will be these two transitions. So, now the word is only accepted if this A is followed by A and B. And now, in computational linguistics, we are done because our deterministic finite automatons, at least in the courses I visited, do not need to be complete because we say that every arc, not every transition, not specified, goes into the error state. But if you are from a computational scientific background, you probably need complete deterministic finite automaton, so I'm adding the error state for you. That means if this A is not followed, is followed by a B and not by AB, then we have a transition to our error state. If this A is not followed by AB but by two A's, then the condition can't be fulfilled anymore. And if I'm not mistaken, then I think there are all missing transitions. And now here I need a loop. So whenever there's an error concerning this condition, and this condition can't be fulfilled anymore because there's an A not followed by AB, then we go in our trip state or error state, and the word is not accepted anymore, or it can't be accepted anymore. So, this is my solution for this task.